Let's go straight to the tips that you can adopt in order to use energy more efficiently. Let's hear first from David Dooley.
Yeah, thank you, Gabriel. I was looking at this challenge, and I tend to think so much about the institutions. You know, in the institutions, we have a collection of individuals, and these individuals are easier to shape when they're together than when they are in separate units in different places. So I'm looking at schools, for example. We have situations in one of our studies that in one particular school, they use 10 trucks of firewood every week for cooking and boiling water, safe water for drinking. And there are about like 1,000 students. Now, if you look at it from a different angle, all these students produce human waste, which human waste can be converted into energy resource. Now, this is a cultural issue that is very important. If these institutions can convert by way of biogas, biogas is simple technology. Put a tank, which is like a pot, direct all this human waste into that tank. It generates a gas which is flammable, which burns. But because we think in the process of producing human waste, we also produce a gas which is not very good in smell. We think also that when you put the human waste together, the gas which you are going to use for cooking or for burning will be that smelling. No, that's not the thing. This is a cultural perception that we need to work on. This institution would be able to generate enough energy to supply for their cooking and boiling water, as well as even supply neighboring communities with that excess energy. This is one tip that institutions should take, not only for schools, it can work for prisons, it can work for hospitals, it can work for hotels, it can work for the army, name it.